Hi from Bugs and Stuff here. So today we're in Scotland, we're in East Lothian at a place called Cove, and we've been staying here for a couple of days in a little cottage. And I had an idea, I thought I'd get in touch with my good friend Richard Gallen and ask them if there's any interesting spiders, any interesting British spiders or UK spiders to find on this part of the world. As you can see, it's a beautiful part of the world. And he came back with a brilliant species called Meta minardi, which, as it happens to be one of the biggest UK spiders. Now, don't get too excited. It's not giant. It's not as big as the tarantulas we normally find on field trips. But I'd like to squeeze in a little bit of spider searching when we're out on any trip, really. So we're heading down to this coastal path. The spider likes to live in really dark places. So it's often called the sea cave spider or the European cave spider because of its liking of habitat, which is really, really dark inside. So inside caves, can be found also inside railway viaducts, railway tunnels, which lose lots of light. Juveniles can be found on the outskirts of the cave systems, but adults tend to be found deep inside where there's no light whatsoever. So fingers crossed, we'll have a look inside and see if we can find any of this amazing spider, Meta minardi, one of the UK's biggest spiders. So we're in April now, and as British spiders go, April's not really the best time to find adults. British spiders tend to mature in the autumn. So when I looked at the records on the British Arachnological Society website, I was quite surprised to find that adults can be found most of the year round, but most of the recorded sightings of these adults are in April. So we're just at Easter time now in the UK, so hopefully the timing's perfect to find one. So this species can be found on both the outside of the cave habitat, but mainly adults are going to be found in the middle where it's nice and dark. They tend to shun bright light. So this looks like the entrance. Wow. Outside, but we're going to move into the darkness and of course switch on some light. So X-axis are teardrop shaped, so that's going to be the first thing we're going to hopefully see inside this tunnel. It's a bit of a man-made tunnel inside the mountainside, inside the hillside. Ah, look, up here. First evidence. Hopefully you can see that. What we've got here is that characteristic egg sac teardrop shape. So we're definitely still here. Adults are going to be found nearer the top. All right, here we go. Right up here, hiding in the corner there. Hopefully you can see that. There's our first one. Hopefully the camera's picking that up. See if there's one further down. It's a cool little spot, isn't it? So yeah, the further we get down into it, the darker it becomes, so that's better for the spider.
like I saw that little female.
Richard Gallen spiders, blah blah blah. Bugger. It's not a cave, guy. It's a scoop.